Hi, I'm Judith Moreland. I was the voice and text director for Eclipsed, the recent production at Milwaukee Rep, directed by Mayor Dralis. And I'm gonna spend a few minutes telling you exactly what a voice and text director does or what a dialect coach does, because I get a lot of questions as to what that is and how it works. Step number one is, of course, reading the play. This play was written by Danai Guerrera, and she had done a lot of research into the Liberian Civil War and war brides before she wrote the play. So she was very specific as to where the play was set, the time, and who these characters were. So all those are clues for the dialect coach as they are for the director. After you read the play, you talk to the director to see what vision she might have for how she wants the story to be told, any specific details about characters or dialect, and then she sends me on my way. I also reached out to the dramaturg for Eclipse to find out what material she had compiled, and she was great. She sent everything to me, so I sat down, read it all, and had a very good idea of who these women were in the play and how they should sound. Step number two is creating a dialect chart once you figure out exactly how you want your dialect to sound. So what I like to do is find someone from that area and mimic them, including all their idiosyncrasies. I think that it just sounds authentic because that person is authentic. So if you sound like them, no one can say, you don't sound like you're from that area, because you actually are sounding like someone who is from that area. So because I couldn't find anyone to tape record and study how they sound, I went to the next best thing, which is the dialect coach's best friend, YouTube. Step three is creating a dialect chart. So I have a couple of examples here. This first one, you can see, is just in pencil, some in pen. These are my notes from what I heard as I was listening to those YouTube samples. And then from that, I come up with a clean version, which is what you can see right there. Now, you might have noticed on the left side of those dialect charts, it looks like there's these weird symbols. Those are actually letters from the International Phonetic Alphabet. The IPA, which is what we call it, the International Phonetic Alphabet, is an alphabet of sounds, not of letters. So every sound ostensibly that any human being makes can be represented by a corresponding symbol in the IPA. I just listen until I start to understand what the patterns of sounds are. The interesting thing about any dialect or any accent, including yours, is that there's a pattern. You might not realize it, but there is a pattern. You listen to the sounds and how they deviate from what is considered the standard non-regionalized version of, in this case, English, because we're English speakers. And then you listen to how those sounds deviate. A great one that they practice in Liberia that you hear in many African dialects is the O diphthong, for instance. So whereas we would say, go home, they turn the sound in many dialects, including Liberia, they change that into something we call a puro. So where we would say, go home, they would say, go home. And right there, you can hear that suddenly I sound like I'm not an American English speaker, but I sound like I'm African, and in this case, Liberian. My next job is to teach that to them. So the first thing a dialect coach asks is, do you guys know the IPA? Because if you do, it makes things very easy. And fortunately, every actor in this cast knew the International Phonetic Alphabet. That's not always the case, but in this case it was, because they're all trained actors. So that makes my job easy. After I came back to Los Angeles, I would continue to work with the actors one-on-one via Skype, or now everybody uses Zoom, so now it would be Zoom, but this was before the pandemic, so we were on Skype. So what that would mean is that I would schedule time with the stage manager. And during their rehearsal time, they would take a half hour out of rehearsal and they would come into a room and we would just work one-on-one, where they would read portions of the script to me. I would listen, I would make corrections. We would go over how you create the sound in your mouth. I haven't talked at all about placement or musicality or exactly where in the mouth you create the sounds. These are all the things that go into creating an authentic dialect. The final step in the process is me being back in Milwaukee with the actors and moving from the rehearsal space to the theater. I actually don't really see the play because my nose is now in my script. I read the words as the actors are acting and I circle sounds that are inconsistent or sounds that I don't understand. I also circle words that need to be emphasized that aren't being emphasized, or words that shouldn't be emphasized that are being emphasized, anything that is not clear in terms of the storytelling. And finally comes the first preview. And that's really kind of my last step. They're about to fly the nest for me. So I went to the first preview where I was able to actually see the play, because usually my nose is down in the script, and I watched a lot of the play, which was just beautiful. It just was visually stunning. The women were fantastic. I also had my script with me, so I was sitting in the back row not to bother any of the audience members. And every time I couldn't understand something or the dialect was too thick, I would make a note in my script or make a note on my notepad to talk to the actors afterwards. We also spend a little bit of time, just so you know, massaging the dialect to help ease an audience that's not used to hearing a Liberian dialect to hear a Liberian dialect. So the dialect that you heard, if you got the opportunity to see Eclipsed, was actually softer in the beginning of the play to get your ears attuned to it, and it became more strict and more authentic as the play progressed, because then you were able to hear it. I also did a little recon during intermission, so people didn't know I was the dialect coach. So I walked around and I kind of listened in to see what people were saying about the dialect. Could they understand it? I asked a couple of people, how was it? And from that, I was also able to make some adjustments. So that's kind of a long explanation of what I do. But I think if anything, hopefully it gives you an appreciation of just how hard these actors work to make it look effortless. Thank you so much. I hope this was interesting, and I really look forward to seeing everybody back in the theater very soon. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay sane. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.